Welcome to the first video in our tutorial series. I'm Anna Luisa Daigneault from Living Tongues Institute for Endangered Languages. Living Dictionaries are collaborative multimedia web tools that can help languages survive for generations to come. There are over 3,000 endangered languages in the world today, and many of them need support. Living Dictionaries address the urgent need to provide comprehensive, freely accessible tech tools for community activists working on grassroots conservation efforts and revitalization programs, as well as for linguists engaged in language documentation. Here we are on our website, livingdictionaries.app. You can browse any of the publicly available dictionaries on the website at any time using the left sidebar. You can change the interface language on the platform by clicking on the language button in the top right of your screen, and you can choose from one of these languages. To create a new Living Dictionary, the first thing you need to do is sign in and create an account on the platform. You can sign in with Google or with any other email. I'll sign in using my Gmail account. Now that I'm signed in, I can create a new Living Dictionary by clicking on the Create New Dictionary in the bottom left. The first thing I need to do is fill out information about this language. So, this important basic information can be changed in the Settings tab later. All of the information we ask for will help us identify your language and your dictionary and make it discoverable through search engines on the internet. If you're having trouble filling anything out, please contact us using the Contact Us button in the top right, and we can assist you via email. The first thing you need to do is type in the name of the language. So today, I'm creating a Living Dictionary for Baure, an endangered language from Bolivia. You can change this name later on. It automatically populates the URL field here. This field actually is permanent, so please avoid any special characters, accents, or diacritics. This is one of the few fields you cannot change in the settings later on, but everything else can be changed. Next, you'll be asked to list the languages that you would like your dictionary to be made available in. So since this language is spoken in Bolivia, I will add Spanish to this project. And then you can add alternate names for your language. Many languages of the world are known by multiple names in the literature, as well as by the communities who speak them. It's important to add alternate names in case someone in the future is searching for this dictionary online by another language name. And you can add more alternate names later in the settings. This language is also known as Baure with an accent, so I'm going to add that in here. Next, we ask you to select where the language is spoken. So I'm going to select the coordinates on the map by dropping a geopin. I'm going to search for Beni Department in Bolivia, which is where this language is spoken. If I have more precise coordinates for latitude and longitude for a specific village or town, I can also change that later. So now I'm going to save this. You can see the geopin is available here. After that, you can type in the ISO-code and glottocode for your language. These codes can be found on Wikipedia and on Glottolog. These codes help linguists and communities identify specific languages and dialects. Some languages might not have these codes. On Wikipedia, we can see that the code for this language is BRG for the ISO code and BAUR1253 for the glotto code. Lastly, we ask you a few different questions to know more about why you're creating this dictionary. This will help our team at Living Tongues understand who you are and how you're connected to the language community that you're creating the dictionary for. Is this dictionary for a language that is spoken or signed by a specific human community? Yes. Has the language community given you permission to make this dictionary? Yes. Please briefly describe how you know this language and why you are creating a Living Dictionary for it. Are you part of the community that will be using this Living Dictionary? If not, how do you know this community? So I have some answers written up here, which I will copy paste here. I'm not part of the Baure community, but I'm in contact with language activists in Bolivia who wish to collect Baure language materials and create a Baure Living Dictionary in collaboration with the indigenous Baure community. I'm acting as a facilitator to get this content online. Lastly, our question is, Is this dictionary for a constructed language, a language invented by humans in recent years for a book or a movie? If yes, please briefly describe. No. So that's what we call a conlang. No, this is not a conlang. This is an indigenous language that is currently endangered. It's spoken by a small number of people in Bolivia. And with that, I can press the blue Create Dictionary button, and I'm taking to the new empty shell for the Bowre Living Dictionary. Stay tuned for our next video where we teach you how to add entries to a living dictionary. Thank you so much for watching.